The fuel the world burns to make electricity, plentiful and polluting, a major contributor to climate change.
Cheap fuel or environmental nightmare? Next on Global Pulse. How these broadcasters are covering the debate over coal. Coal-fired plants generate nearly half the electricity in the U.S. It's hard to escape the debate over its future as an energy source when TV ads like these try to sway opinion.
In America, there's an energy you can feel, generated by our most abundant fuel, coal.
Clean coal harnesses the awesome power of the word clean to make it sound like the cleanest clean there is.
The debate rages in the U.S. news media as well. Fox highlights the financial costs of stricter regulations on coal.
West Virginia, coal country. Coal mining and power drive the economy here. So the president's plan to fight climate change by taxing carbon pollution is a serious threat.
800 families just totally depend on the good health care and the retirement and the good wages that we're able to provide.
It's cheaper than solar, which costs 20 cents to produce 1 kilowatt hour. Wind costs 14 cents per kilowatt hour. Coal costs only 3 cents.
CNN covered a state-of-the-art coal plant in North Carolina, but pointed out a big flaw.
Duke Energy, one of the largest power providers in the United States, is constructing an 825-megawatt coal plant.
The stack is where the final flue gas will go out after it's been treated, and you'll see a big cloud of water vapor coming out the top of that. SO2, or sulfur, will be reduced by 80%. NOx will be reduced by 50%, and mercury will be reduced by 50%. So it's a significant environmental impact.
What Duke has down in Cliffside is a very advanced coal plant, but still does nothing about the carbon dioxide problem, their main gas behind global warming.
The energy industry has another argument. There's a way to capture carbon emissions. But ABC News says, not so fast.
Worse than the soot that can be seen is the invisible carbon dioxide gas produced by coal. The clean coal theory is to remove and capture the carbon dioxide gases, then ship the gas by pipeline to be buried deep inside the earth. But there's no proof the dangerous gases stay buried. Despite ambitious plans, there is not a single clean coal power plant in operation in the U.S.
A report by NBC showed how strict environmental regulations in Europe are spurring clean coal technology that's already being tested in Germany.
The pilot plant burns its coal with pure oxygen, a cleaner process than using air. And the pollutants are filtered out. Once the carbon is captured, it's buried more than 2,000 feet below the Earth's surface. This process could increase electric rates by 50%, but a bargain, supporters claim, compared to the high price European companies already pay, and American companies may have to for emitting CO2.
China is the world's biggest coal user. According to NPR, China is expected to construct as many as 500 new coal plants in the next decade. CCTV describes why Beijing is in such a hurry.
Household appliances have to run almost 24 hours a day in many southern provinces this winter due to the extremely cold weather. Power plants have already been running to full capacity. And although demand is surging, power companies don't have enough coal to generate any more electricity.
The New York Times reported that China's leading the world in construction of cleaner coal-fired plants. But coal is still a big contributor to the nation's pollution crisis. Al Jazeera found another, more human toll it's taking on the Chinese.
China has over 5 million miners. The production line never stops. Tens of thousands of miners are critically injured a year. Mr. Shaolun suffers from acute emphysema, a lung disorder caused by years of inhaling coal dust. He's checked into the coal miners' sanatorium to have his lungs cleaned out for the second time. As a manager in one of the leading state-run companies, he qualified, one of only 900 miners a year, to receive this life-saving operation.
The U.S. government projects coal use will grow significantly over the next 20 years. Parallel to that growth will be an increase in global carbon emissions. For Global Pulse, I'm Erin Coker.
This program is brought to you by Link TV, for educational and non-commercial use only. Link TV is the only U.S. network dedicated to global and national news, uncompromising documentaries, and diverse cultural programs. Programs which connect you to the world.